Well, first, what influence did you get for this film? Because it has like a similar, like Carrie. I thought of Carrie when I saw the script.
I guess what we wanted to do was a supernatural thriller, but a more allegorical human version. It's not blood and guts. It's more a story of an internal struggle of a young woman who's trying to experience love for the first time and finds it very difficult because her parents are very conservative and she falls in love with a girl. So it's a story of accepting who you really are.
You're focused on human dramas usually. What how does this project contribute for your kind of cinema?
I think doing something that was a bit more sinister and mysterious was kind of liberating for me, because I've done these dramas, I guess you call them, previously. This film gave me an opportunity to do something more nightmarish and moody with cinema, you know, with the camera, with the mood of the images. And a lot of fun things, people on fire and snakes and underwater sequences, and you really have fun with this one. I learned a lot. It was a good experience.
Next question. Rumor says you're a distant relative of Lars von Trier. Is that true or just internet?
It's hard to say. It's really hard. Someone should ask him. I think we are related far out in our families.
Well, first, how did you prepare for this role, considering you have epileptic seizures during the film?
Yeah, there were a lot of preparations for this part. Particularly, it was I did seizure therapy, and I did swimming and diving lessons for the underwater scenes as well. Seizure therapy is very interesting. It's usually for people with traumatic experiences, and they do seizure therapy to be able to cope with that, in a sense. But for me, it was a way of use that as a basis and then work off of that when portraying and expressing those seizures. It's a lot of breathing and yoga exercises, which makes your muscles tremble, and then it turns out that this wave of trembling that looks more organic than just, shaking.
You were working with people who had epilepsy as well?
If I did? No, I interviewed some who suffers from epilepsy, but I saw, actually there are a lot of seizures online, so I watched a lot of them, but you know, Thelma, the character, she doesn't really suffer from epilepsy, so I had the opportunity to be more creative in a sense in what way I wanted to portray those specific seizures.
And how would you describe the connection between both characters?
You mean me and Kaya Wilkins? It was great working with her. She's just, I think she's incredible. This is her first feature film. She's a musician, and I think her sensitivity is just very, very clear in the film as well. And I think she gets that from her music and performing in that sense. She came in on the audition. I just had my fingers crossed the whole time it will be her to portray the character.
And do you have any upcoming projects?
No, not yet.
We'll see. Thank you very much.
Thanks.